Scott, what led you down a different road after STS-118 to begin training for a ride to the space station in a Soyuz vehicle and training to become a space station commander? And for Mark, why did you remain on a shuttle path rather than following your brother's footsteps to go for Soyuz and Russian training?
My, after STS-103, one of the crew members on 103 was Mike Fall, who was also at the time, doing double duties as a, associate center director, I think was his title. And, he thought I would be a good person to be the, what's called the director of operations in Star City. So, we talked about that, and I decided that maybe, that'd be a good experience. Never intending to get on this space station track as soon as I did. I thought my career would be flying a couple shuttle flights as a pilot and then a couple as the shuttle commander, and then later maybe flying a long duration flight. But then, after I was the DOR, Director of Operations in Star City for, about 9 months, soon after I got back, I thought I was gonna, get assigned as a pilot again, but for whatever reason, the chief of the astronaut office decided to ask me to be a backup for Expedition 5, and the plan was for me not to fly as the prime, but just be the backup. And he said he would then assign me as the commander of a shuttle flight, and then the commander of the space station. Actually, wound up, being true. What he said was the plan for me, but it just because of the Columbia accident, obviously took much longer. But it wasn't really something I was particularly interested in at the time. I would have rather flown the two pilot flights and two commander flights, but being just the, military type of guy I am, I couldn't say no. And I said, well, if that's what you want me to do, that's what I'll do.
So Rob, you asked that question like we have a lot of control over this, and we actually really don't. I mean, it's not like you go into the office and you say, hey, I want to be on this flight, and then I want to be on this one. It's really, the chief of the astronaut office, Peggy Whitson now, I mean, she makes the decisions of, who is on which flight. And it's, to a large extent, it's really out of your control. In my case, I've been fortunate enough to fly, three shuttle flights so far. And this flight, which I think will wind up being the last flight of Space Shuttle Endeavor. And it's been, certainly a great opportunity and a privilege to get to do that.
Scott, how different is it going to be when you strap into a Soyuz vehicle, knowing you're basically a passenger in the right seat, heading uphill with your knees up in your throat, very tight capsule, Mercury style, basically, Gemini maybe at the most. What do you think that's going to be like in contrast?
Well, I'll certainly have a lot less to do than during that time in the Soyuz than on a shuttle ascent or entry for that matter. As the flight engineer number two, you're sort of a passenger. You do have some responsibilities, but you're it's kind of like being somewhere between mission specialist number one on a shuttle and sitting on the mid deck. Your role. In that regard, it will be different. It's kind of neat that it's a rocket, like a traditional rocket. So it'll be good to have that experience, especially as we move on to a new vehicle after the space shuttle program.
Mark, you're going to be traveling to the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan to watch your brother's launch. What do you think that's going to be like for you?
I've only been to Russia once, and it was a long time ago, so I'm looking forward to that. I'm actually taking Russian classes right now to see if I can get a little bit of Russian language ability. I kind of quit. I quit last week, but I did a couple months. For me, it's really a great opportunity to not only see another space launch with people on board, but to see my brother climbing into the Soyuz and launching from another country. I mean, it's going to be amazing. I think at least one of my parents are going to be there, one of our parents, a lot of friends, some other family members. So it's really something I'm really looking forward to.
And for you, Scott, knowing that your brother's there, not necessarily next to you, but certainly in spirit? How's that going to be from a support standpoint mentally for you?
That'll be great. And, you know, I'll have friends and other family members there. He's going to be one of the family escorts. Hopefully, at least one of my kids will be there. And so it'll be good that he's there, you know, with my daughter.
And then if something happens to him, just like accidentally, you know, and he can't fly, he's got another backup.